Beckman. He's also been a tremendous leader for the Baltimore Ravens defense and for the city of Baltimore, period. And I, you know, from the day that he stepped on the field, he's had an impact till now. And that is so rare for any player to have such an impact, having played for this length of time. So he will go down as one of the greatest linebackers, period, to play in the National Football League.
And we know it's his last game. We had Donald Driver from the Packers on yesterday on our show announced he was retired, thinks he could probably play some more, but with his family doesn't want to go to another team, so wants to end it. Going back to the end of your career,
no, I think I can still play.
Well, see, I mean, we all
think we can play.
Did you know when you were going to end? I mean, did you?
Well, you know, Bill Parcells, we had all kinds of conversations, and he came to me one day and he said, you know, just in conversation, he said, you know, before anybody else, that's not good. And in retrospect, he was so correct. When you know that as a middle linebacker, I can't get to the edge or the corner when that running back is running a sweep, if I can't get there the way I used to be able to get there in my first year, I know it's time to go. Now, you can play, and you can fool yourself, and you can fool the coaches, but you know when it's time to go. And if you have any kind of pride within yourself, you call the shots and not have them show you the door. And that's the way that I've always tried to be, just play to the best of my ability and not have people say, look at that person out there. I feel so bad.
He's hanging out.
He's hanging on. You know, I never wanted that for me and my career. So you have to know when it's time to go.
Harry Carson with us on Mike and Mike in the Morning. You got some attention some weeks ago. You called into Michael Kay's show on ESPN New York and the subject, of course, about head injuries and your future health and the long-term health, I guess, of the game of football has been such a big one in recent times in and around football. And you made a comment that you had a grandson and that you wanted to get golf clubs in his hands rather than football. I'd love you to expand on that a little bit here and give your thoughts on the long-term health you think of the game of football itself with all of these concerns.
Well, you know, it's interesting. I was trained to be an educator, not necessarily a football player. I fell into football. And so I look at football from a much different perspective than so many other guys who played the game. If I played football, I wouldn't have been a teacher or a professor or whatever. And so I listened to my own body, and I knew things were going on. Even when I played, I knew something was going on, but I couldn't really put the finger on it until I recognized after my career that I was having some neurological issues. So as a result, I followed things that were happening with me, but also I've gone to conferences, I've sat before some of the world's foremost professionals when it comes to neurological situations. And I've learned a lot about this. Now, I started talking about this on ESPN about 1994, 1995. I mean, there are people around the country who thought I was crazy. But this is such a hot button topic now. This is something that I've come to grips with for a long time. And, you know, through the whole stint of the Hall of Fame and waiting and so forth, I saw so many players who were smart, sound players, and they started to experience all kinds of problems. And when various players recognized or realized that I was talking about it, they reached out to me. There are so many players who reached out to me, and they told me that they're having neurological problems. And I knew that if I was having these problems, there are probably so many other guys who have the same problems. So this is something that I saw years ago, and I felt a little suicidal when I played and dealing with depression. So it doesn't surprise me that other players who are having these neurological issues, but they don't know, because we're trained to be physical and be mental, but we are not trained to think from a neurological standpoint what's going on, because it's the brain, and the brain controls everything. And so when guys start having these issues, then they don't know what's going on, and they can literally think that they're going crazy. So, you know, I've tried to put my message out there about playing the game and about the issues that I've dealt with, and I've been very much identified with so many other players right now. You know, not just the players who are having neurological problems now, but those players who preceded me who are now dealing with dementia and Alzheimer's and Lou Gehrig's disease. So, you know, this is something that I know all too well.
Carson's been talking about this for a long time on with us here on Mike and Mike in the Morning, and also is here today to make sure that men are aware of their statistics when it comes to prostate cancer, which is a very significant issue for all men, really of all ages.
Yes.
And the website is knowyourstats.org.
Yeah, you know, I've been getting my prostate exam since I was like 37. I always go to the doctor every year. And I put myself out there as a former player trying to connect with men that if I can do it as a big, strong football player, any man should be able to do it. Get your prostate examined, especially if you're after the age of 40. If prostate cancer comes in your family, you need to know what your stat is. So it's a very curable disease if caught early. 1 in 6 men will probably have to deal with prostate cancer. I have a number of friends now who, you know, 10, 20 years ago, never even, you know, knew anything about a prostate exam, and now they're dealing with prostate cancer. And so some of my best friends are dealing with it. So at this age where we are now, especially if you're African American, there's a higher risk. If you have it in your family, it's a higher risk. So you really need to know your stuff. If men don't want to do it for themselves, they really need to do it for their families. Do it for your wives, do it for your kids. Be around. For me, I want to be around to see my equipment, my package, grow old and have the best time that I can have with them.
And put those golf clubs.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Good to see you, Harry Carson. Yeah, thank you for coming by. The Hall of Famer, Harry Carson. Drew Brees is on the way. Stone Cold Leg Pipe Locks for the Super Bowl are next. Mike and Mike in the Morning.
ESPN Radio.
Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. It's where America goes to play.
Hey, go.
Let me ask her.
Let me ask you this. What are you going to do with your tax refund this year?
Taxes? Who wants to do something?
Well, when you get done with your W-2s, put your refund to work for you at AutoZone.
Right.
From brakes to engine parts, AutoZone has the quality parts, low prices, and expert advice you need to take care of your car. Now is the best time when that refund can go a long way at AutoZone. Before that small job today becomes an even bigger job tomorrow.
So make sure you do one thing. That's get in the zone today.
Let's start a movement to leave more impact. It starts with Reprieve, a fiber that contains recycled plastic bottles. And it really gets going when you choose a fleece beanie, a jacket, even a pair of pants made from Reprieve. So let's get everyone
to recycle plastic bottles.
Buy recycled products.
And join our green movement on Facebook.
That's Reprieve, R-E-P-R-E-V-E.
Together, we can make a better world. Because there's no I in Reprieve.
Reprieve, it's what's in it. Proud recycling partner, X Games Aspen 2013.
Now it's time for your local sports blitz.
I guess you could call it Girls Night Out at the Big Atlantic Basketball Classic last night. Here's the way the scores looked in the girls' action. George Washington, 59. Preston, 48. Green Rider East keeps on rolling, 65-39 over St. Albans. Parkersburg South, 66. Nicholas County, 36. And a tough loss for Westside. University, 57. Westside, 46. Other girls' games. Buffalo, 39. Hayes Valley Christian, 32. Cabo Midland, 61. American, 49. Clay County, 62. Mocha, 44. George Washington, 59. Capital, 48. Mingo Central, 51. Tug Valley, 42. Shady Spring, 53. Oak Hill, 24. South Charleston, 48. Nitro, 31. Spring Valley, 75. Winfield, 45. And St. Mary's, 71. Tyler Consolidated, 49. In boys high school basketball action last night, Cross Lanes Christian, 57, Van, 38. Greater Beckley Christian, 75, Van, 55. Liberty Raleigh, 78, Nicholas County, 55. Ritchie County, 76, Ravenswood, 62. And Webster County defeated Braxton County, 56-38. I'm Dave Kirby, make it a great day.
Changing your own motor oil can save you money and time, but it can also be messy. From the moment the drain plug comes out, it's anyone's guess where the oil will land. Keep it clean, quick, and easy with an oil change kit from O'Reilly Auto Parts on sale for $5. It includes shop towels, a funnel, drain pan, and hand cleaner. O'Reilly Auto parts, better prices every day.
Oh, O'Reilly Auto Parts.
I love you.
Oh, I love you.
Samsung.
Wait, did you just call me Samsung?
What? No, of course not, Janet. That is totally silly. Look, we've been together a long time. Come on. Of course I know your name is Panasonic.
I'm going to my sister's.
Sony, what did I do?
Big screen TVs on the brain. Get to Sears or Sears.com/football before the game for huge savings on top TV brands. This is the ultimate football experience. This is Sears.
When you're thinking about buying a new car or truck, think Buckley Auto Care. We're West Virginia's number one volume GMC dealer and Buckley's only Buick dealer. Buick is the face of affordable luxury. Buckley Auto Mall has every Buick model in all their beautiful splendor, like the turbocharged Buick Regal GS and brand new Encore with excellent fuel economy. And if it's a truck you're looking for, we've got not only the best looking trucks, we've got the best made trucks in America. And there's one more reason to buy from Buckley Auto Mall, and you can sum that up in one word: service. And you don't have to take my word for it. Look around you on the road in southern West Virginia. You may notice there are a lot of GMCs around. That's because once you buy from Beckley Auto Mall, you always buy from Beckley Auto Mall. We back everything we sell to keep you coming back. Beckley Auto Mall, proud to serve you, southern West Virginia. Best selection, best price, best service after the sale. Beckley Auto Mall. What about Seabird? How's it going to drive?
Carl Mack at the Ticket Weather Center. Snow showers likely this morning, mostly cloudy the rest of the day with a high near 19. New snow accumulation of around an inch is possible. Tonight partly cloudy and cold with a low 11. Saturday snow, mostly in the afternoon, high near 30. Saturday night snow, low 25. And for Sunday, snow showers likely mostly in the morning, cloudy with a high near 31.
Hey, this is Josh Schimmel from the Southern West Virginia Kings Warriors. You're listening to ESPN Radio 102.3 FM, The Ticket.
Defense. I think man for man, pound for pound, the 49er offensive line is
is better than the Ravens' offensive line. I like Kaepernick sort of in a because there's such different styles. I'll sort of take Kaepernick by a nose over even Flacco as well as he's playing right now. I'll take Frank Gore by a nose over Ray Rice as far as their effectiveness running the football against the opposition defense here. So everything in the world seems to lead towards the 49ers winning this game. I think they're the better team. But there was something about that moment where that ball went over the outstretched hands of Raheem Moore in Denver at the very end of regulation 2 weeks ago that made me say, and you know I believe in this stuff.
I know you do.
Tend not to. That the Ravens are a team of destiny. I don't know if it is Ray Lewis playing in his last game. I don't know if the football gods want to reward him for whatever reason. I don't know if it's because they should have beaten New England last year and they didn't get it done. For whatever reason, I think that the Ravens are a team that just isn't going to lose. I will take the Baltimore Ravens to beat the San Francisco 49ers in Super Bowl 47, 22-16, and Ray Lewis rides off into the sunset as a Super Bowl champ. That is my stone-cold lead pipe.
I
have not made it too much of a secret about which way I'm going. I picked Baltimore to win the Super Bowl at the beginning of the season, and I want to look good if I pick. So I understand what you're saying about San Francisco being maybe the better team right now. I'm certainly leaning toward Baltimore. You said the defense for San Francisco is better than Baltimore. True, except this postseason. The Baltimore defense is actually playing better. I give them the credit for that. They're creating turnovers. Yeah, Kaepernick a little bit over Joe Flacco. I disagree. I'll take Joe Flacco. Joe Flacco, what he's doing in the postseason. You look at what Matt Ryan did to get that early lead against San Francisco. Flacco has every bit of the ability Matt Ryan does. Maybe not as good of receivers, but his receivers are excellent receivers. I think he can go vertical on this team. I think that helps Ray Rice in the running game in front of a big offensive line that has switched positions, but they're gelling very, very nicely. So I lean toward Baltimore, and that's certainly with San Francisco. I think they have the best offensive line in the game. If that read option starts working, Baltimore could be in trouble, and the defense we know is fantastic. But I just like the way this has been the last few years of how are you playing when it matters the most. And right now, Baltimore's cooking. Flacco hasn't thrown the interception. The defense is playing a lot better. I don't believe in your destiny. I don't believe in your fate. I believe in what happens on the football field. And I believe the Baltimore Ravens are playing some of their best football right now. I think that continues in the Super Bowl. I also think, and I picked them at the beginning of the year, now although I picked them to play against the Philadelphia Eagles in the Super Bowl, I didn't get that right, but I did pick the Ravens to win the Super Bowl. I'm sticking with that. Baltimore beat San Francisco in Super Bowl 47 by the score of 27-24.
So let it be written.
So let it be done.
Mike and Mike at our Stone Cold Lead Pipe Locks are brought to you by Peak Antifreeze. When you peak, you win. So we both go with the Ravens on Sunday in what I think is going to be a little bit of a surprise pick as far as most are concerned. Certainly yesterday down at Radio Row, the sense I got is that there is a much more of a sentiment that the 49ers will win this game quickly, because I don't like making a pick to try and justify a pick you made at the start of the season. Had you not made that pick, would you still be taking the Ravens right now?
The way they're playing, I still would probably lean toward them, because it's what have you done for me lately right now. Lately, they're playing pretty darn well.
They certainly are. Ravens and Niners getting set to play Super Bowl 47. We'll do a Super Bowl special on Sunday morning where we will have Liam's mom making her official Super Bowl prediction. But up next, the crowd here is going to get a little excited. Drew Brees is coming up to see us, the quarterback of the hometown Saints. He's live next on our Super Bowl from New Orleans in just a moment.
At Advance Auto Parts, we got hot deals on a cold day and cool deals when it's hot. Currently, it's chilly out. So here's a sizzler from Advance. Deep 50-50 antifreeze. A one-gallon jug is just $9.99. That's a $3 savings. And that'll keep your car running through the cold like a white bull through a blizzard. Deep 50-50 antifreeze. Just $9.99. That's cold throttle savings. Only at Advance Auto Parts. She's going to be dead.
Ready for some love?
RINAI.US to see how RINAI tankless water heaters can set you free.
It's so hot. I
you identify and stop investment scams in their tracks. A free program called Seniors Against Investment Fraud is being offered throughout West Virginia. To schedule this presentation for your organization, call the State Auditor's Office toll-free at 888-SAIFWBA or visit WBSAO.gov.
First year Texas Tech basketball coach Chris Walker has a background in the Big East Conference. He started 96 games as a guard at Villanova, playing for Coach Charlie Massimino, and a playing career that ended in the early 1990s. Walker had two stints as an assistant coach at Villanova, the latest between 2009 and 2011, working for Wildcats coach Jay Wright.
Jay's one of my biggest mentors ever. I mean, one thing I learned from Jay is you have to create a culture of caring and realizing that everyone has the same role with different statuses, and you need that type of hard, smart, together, playing with pride, and that can translate to work smart, work hard, work together, work with pride. The way the program building aspect of what he brings to the table, and just learning that. And I think every coach, you know, needs to be in a situation where they learn how to build that program.
Walker was an assistant at Texas Tech last year. He took over the head coaching duties prior to the start of this season, and he talked about the obvious differences between Villanova and the Big East compared to Texas Tech in the Big 12.
I noticed it from day one when I came to Villanova. Just first of all, you see the football stadium, and then all of a sudden you see the on-campus arenas, and you're like, wow, with the lack of pro atmosphere, you know, from the big city standpoint, it just lends itself to being more, you know, fan-friendly to students, to alumni and stuff. That's something, that's the big event they look forward to going to, as opposed to going to the program. It creates a more fervent fan environment, and I really enjoy it. That's one of the big things I enjoy is, you know, even Texas Tech with the guns up and just the pageantry, the history, the yell calls and all that. I mean, it's really, you know, playing the fight song is something that, you know, people feel very passionate about. So.
The Mountaineers travel today. They'll play at Texas Tech at 1:30 tomorrow. With the Golden Blue Report, I'm Kyle Wiggs, Metro News Sports.
I was all geared up for the party where I'd finally meet Kate, my dream girl. But there was no party, all because I got the flu. If only I got a flu vaccine. Sam got one. Sam went to the party, and he's going to another one tonight with Kate, which I'm missing since 4 days later. I'm still down with aches, chills, and fever.
Flu is a serious illness for everyone, even really healthy people. So get vaccinated. Find a location nearby at flu.gov. Brought to you by HHS.
Attention business owners and managers. The 2013 Women's Expo is coming to the Beckley Raleigh County Convention Center the weekend of March 2nd and 3rd. It promises to be bigger and better than ever, and your business can be a part of the largest vendor show in Southern West Virginia. Get your business in front of thousands of customers at the 2013 Women's Expo. Call our expo line now at 304-461-9287. Don't miss the 2013 Women's Expo, presented by Unicare and Sunrise.
I'm Carl Mack at the Ticket Weather Center. Snow showers likely this morning, mostly cloudy the rest of the day with a high near 19. New snow accumulation of around an inch is possible. Tonight partly cloudy and cold with a low 11. Saturday snow, mostly in the afternoon, high near 30. Saturday night snow, low 25. And for Sunday, snow showers likely mostly in the morning, cloudy with a high near 31.
ESPNRadio.com.
ESPN Radio is 102.3, The Ticket, WMTD-FM, Hinton, Princeton, Beckley, and on the web at theticket102.com.
ESPN Radio Sports Center.
All right, everybody, just got excited here in New Orleans because the Saints quarterback, Drew Brees, will join us right after this Sports Center, which begins, Golic, with a moment that was about a quarter of an inch away from being really special.
Yeah, I know you love golf, but we know Drew Brees is a quarterback, so he loves golf. Both had to be excited, and Phil Mickelson was inches away from hitting a 25-foot birdie putt in his last hole to shoot a 59 at the Phoenix Open. It lifts out. He shoots a 60. It's the second time he has shot a 60 in his career. NBA Thunder beats Grizzlies 106-89. Kevin Durant goes to 27. Warriors beat the Mavs 100-97. Top 15 in college basketball. Number 7, Gonzaga over Loyola Marymount. Number 8, Arizona over Washington. Number 9, Butler falls to St. Louis. And number 13, Michigan State beats Illinois. Tomorrow, big matchup on ESPN, 9 o'clock Eastern. Number 1, Michigan at number 3, Indiana. That's SportsCenter, and it's brought to you by the full juicy flavor of Johnsonville sausage. Visit Johnsonville.com for affordable recipes that are perfect for game time or anytime. Johnsonville sausage is all we do.
Coming up at this time on Sunday morning, I should probably remind you that Mike and Mike's live Super
tradition, Mike and Mike will chat with the commissioner, Roger Goodell.
Boss, we've still got a lot to get to today.
Hall of Famers, Mike Ditka, Steve Young, Jerry Rice,
the great Roger Staubach,
Packers receiver Greg Jennings,
and Super Bowl champion Trent Dilfer.
Now, live from New Orleans, here's Mike and Mike.
Here we are, Mike and Mike in the morning on ESPN Radio and live on your TV on ESPN2. We are presented by Progressive Insurance, and it is our pleasure to welcome a guy who's fairly popular in this town. Judging by the noise behind us, the terrific quarterback of the New Orleans Saints. Here's Drew Brees. Good to see you, Drew. How are you?
See you guys. Very well.
Well, wow. I mean, it's almost like a One Direction concert. I was saying that to Brees in the break, that if you really wanted to impress people, all this, you know, 5,000 yards business in Super Bowl was nice. But when you did a commercial with Harry from One Direction, my 12-year-old daughter now is a big Drew Brees fan. That must have been something.
That's good to know. Did she hear me sing, though, and then change her mind?
Oh, no. We live while we're young.